down to the stream to play in the water. People ride us like horses, and we can pull carts and wagons. We helped clear the roads after the typhoons here recently. We also serve as pickup trucks and buses to get the workers and their equipment out to the gardens and the fields. This is a rice field where my mom and dad work. It's the biggest source of income for my Pepper family. Here's Dad and the neighbor's boy teamed up together to prepare the field for planting. Mom and Dad worked together to pull the plow to make the rows for my Pepper family to plant their rice. It's muddy work, but it's wonderful to keep cool in very hot tropical temperatures. After a day of field work, we all meet their co-workers at the community bath. Every day, when we get home, we get a serious bath and a final rinse so that we don't get a tick-borne disease. If we didn't fight the bath or run away from the kids, we get a reward when we get home from work. To stay healthy from that tick-borne disease, we go to a heifer community clinic twice a year. We line up by a corral and get a shot that's good protection. And we get to see all of our other family over there. We get pills and medicine that taste bad twice a year, but our heifer farmers couldn't afford to lose us. This is a passing on the gift ceremony. It's like my graduation day. I'm glad Barb got to come. I got old enough to become pregnant so my heifer family could give me to another family. This fulfills their heifer contract and makes me very proud. My new heifer owner is a widow with five children to play with. She's desperately poor, but I will help her change that very quickly. She can plant four times as much rice with my help. I even have my own pool in her backyard. I will never forget my first heifer family, but it will be so nice to help my new heifer mom and her kids. My heifer dad told Barb this when she was here. If I die, my family will be sad, but if my water buffalo dies, they will die. My new heifer family doesn't have a dad, so I'm going to be really important to her. I will make them healthy with my milk and help her make enough money to send all the kids to school. You probably can't come visit me, but I sure thank you for sending some water buffaloes here for all of my neighbors. But if you can, go down to Heifer's Ranch, Arkansas, and say hi to my uncles. So I brought you some pins and some pencils. I think there's some cow pins in there, and there's some buffalo pins in there, and there's some cards with animals on.
Good morning, everyone. Beverly and I come here. You know that alternative giving has been busy again. And in this case, it's for Heifer International. When we first started 18 years ago, and we've been doing that now thanks to your contributions, one of our first projects was the Heifer International project, where you could buy different animals and put them on a ship and send them overseas to help other people. Well, we finally found out that there was a thing called the ARC, which consists of $5,000 to a pair of animals that go overseas to all different places. We had ducks, geese, goats, pigs, water buffalo, I think. We had a few people give their mamas some llamas. And I think we have at least one mama llama here in the congregation this morning. Other than that, she will be made anonymous. This morning we're here to congratulate you on the 11th filling of the 11th ARC. We had asked Tom to come up and be the official recipient for the congregation. This plaque from Heifer International, which states, First United Methodist Church, Champaign, Illinois, 11th ARC, 2015. So on behalf of everyone here, we thank you. Heifer International thanks you, and we hope that we will continue on the 12th ARC. And Tom, if you accept this one. Then I'd like to ask someone else to join us this morning. Is there a Reverend Thomas D. Quorum here this morning someplace? It's with the llama. Oh! Anonymous, huh? Well, in our past arcs, we have dedicated one arc or a few arcs to people for special occasions. And today we have a special occasion that occurred earlier than I guess in July, it was. Also on this is a special gift for our minister, Reverend Quorum, and it says, First United Methodist Church, in honor of Reverend Thomas B. Quorum's 25th, is it 25th?
Well, we say
ordination anniversary. He's been preaching to all of us for 25 years now. So in that honor, we have one plaque for him and one for the church.
Hear these words from the Gospel according to Matthew, the 25th chapter, beginning with the 31st verse. Jesus says, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, 'Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you? And the king will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me. Thus ends the reading of the scripture.
Thank you so much for allowing me to come and share with you this morning and celebrate your art contribution. I want to share with you some of the features of heifer that we do that are more than what you normally think of with just the animals. So we start out with Dan West's vision. Most of you probably know about Dan. He was the founder of heifer. He served as a refugee worker in Spain during the Spanish Civil War. And his job was passing out powdered milk to the people in line with cups. But every day they ran out. Dan was from northeastern Indiana, and he knew that the dairy cows back home were what these people needed, not powdered milk. So within 4 years of him coming back to Indiana, he had convinced enough people that this was a good idea, that they started donating cows, and they had enough ready for the first shipment. But then World War II had broken out, and they couldn't send them to Europe as he planned. So the first shipment went in 1944 to Puerto Rico, including 17 heifers. These are the seagoing cowboys. Starting around 1944, 44 different nations got together and started the United Nations Rehabilitation Administration and said, we need to help put Europe back together. They wanted to take livestock to Europe on ships that had been transport ships for soldiers and artillery ships. And they were converted for livestock, but they didn't have anybody to take care of the livestock. So they went to the Church of the Brethren and Dan's community to ask for people to volunteer to be what we call the seagoing cowboys and go with this livestock and take care of them for weeks at a time on the rolling seas. One of the features of heifer is accountability and record keeping. I've had the opportunity, as Tom told you, to go to 7 different countries and see our projects in action. Now, unfortunately, each one of these pictures, I could probably talk as much time as I have this morning about, so I apologize for staying with a script, kind of, sort of, but that's the only way I can keep it within your time limit. This picture shows the first shipment of cows that went to Poland in the upper left-hand corner, and then a cow that a lady was receiving in 2003 when I was there. Because of the accountability that heifer requires and the record keeping, we can often trace the lineage of these cattle in this time period all the way back to those ones that came right after World War II. Passing on the gift is a feature I'm sure you're all aware of. Each family who receives livestock from heifer commits to passing on the firstborn female offspring of the animal that they got to someone else in their project. And they also pass along the training that they received on the care of that animal. This was my first passing on the gift ceremony in Poland. This is a Dobra red cow. They had almost been decimated by the war, and heifer helped them bring this breed back. Sustainability is a very strong feature of all of heifer's projects. Every project from the very beginning has to have a plan of how they are going to be able to stand on their own 2 feet once heifer's support is over. This Polish cattle project that Red Cow came from, the farmers were pooling their income, and they were buying these cooling machines one at a time as they could afford them for each farmer in the project. This allows them to get a higher price for their milk, and the dairy comes right to their farm and picks it up. Gender